Good morning, guys. It's Miss Angie with our Sunday school lesson for March the 7th, 2021. And I want to show you a picture to start with this morning. Take a look at this. What in the world is going on in this picture? It looks like some animals, maybe on a blanket or a sheet. But they're just floating in the air. What could this picture mean? And who is the person in the picture? What could it have to do with the church? I wish I could hear your answers. I'd be really interested to see what you think. That was kind of a weird picture. Not one that we would think of maybe when we think about Sunday school or the Bible or even Jesus or God, but I promise you the picture that you saw is actually a story from the Bible, and we know that all stories from the Bible actually happened. So I'm anxious to share this story with you today. I want you to take a look at another picture right now. So there are lots of foods in this picture. I want you to think about the foods that you would eat, that you like, and maybe the foods that you would never eat because you don't like to eat those foods. Take a look at it, make your choices. So the reason I had you look at those foods was today's story actually has something to do with food as well. We're going to learn that the Jewish people had a lot of rules and laws about what they could and could not eat. Some things were considered clean and they could eat them, but some things were considered unclean, and Jewish law said that they could not eat those things. So that also goes along with our story today. Lots of curious things for us to explore, but we're going to find out all about them. I do want to tell you, we are in a brand new study. So you guys know that we are studying the Bible in 3 years. We're going to cover from Genesis to Revelation, and we're actually getting closer and closer and closer to Revelation. The last part of the Bible that we're going to study is called the Church United. United means together. So the church is coming together. And for the next 4 weeks, I believe, we are going to be studying some people called Jews, which we've heard of many, many times, and Gentiles, which you're going to know all about by the time we finish today. So I'm excited that you're here. I'm going to open us up in a prayer, and then we will get started in our lesson. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I am so grateful for all of the boys and girls and their families that are watching this lesson, and I want to pray that you would bless them and protect them. Lord, I just ask that you would help them to focus and learn about you. I pray that you would give them a hunger for your word, God, and in times that seem crazy, you are going to be our rock. So I pray for all of our kids at Bethel to stand firm on your solid rock. Thank you for loving us. Thank you for sending Jesus. Thank you for giving us the church. And we pray for our church, especially over the next few weeks as we get ready to head back into the building and be together in our newly expanded sanctuary and church with new classrooms. I'm so excited for the boys and girls to see all those things. Thank you, Lord, for that, and just be with us as we make choices and decisions about that. And we thank you again for all the blessings that you've given us. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Here are some funny guys to explain to us the difference between a Jew and a Gentile.
Have I heard the word Gentile before?
I know what it is. It's like a reptile, but more gentle. A gentle reptile is a Gentile.
I'm pretty sure it's not.
No, it isn't. As we've learned, Jews were the children of Israel who were still faithful to God, mostly from the tribes of Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. If you were Jewish, you saw the world as two groups, Jews and everybody else. And they called the everybody else Gentiles. Thanks to all the Pharisees' rules, most Jews wouldn't even talk to Gentiles.
Oh, so the world was made up of Jews and Gentiles, and a Gentile was anyone who wasn't a Jew. Gentle reptiles aren't Jews, so therefore, gentle reptiles are Gentiles.
Your logic almost works, but not quite.
Yes.
That was interesting to hear the difference between Jews and Gentiles. This is what you need to know. Jews were the Israelite people that we heard about all through the Old Testament, and Jesus was a Jew. But we know that if you're not a Jew, you are considered a Gentile. That means I'm a Gentile, and you're probably a Gentile too, because my family didn't come from Israel, or my ancestors weren't from Israel. But here's the great thing. God promised that he didn't just love the Jewish people, his chosen people. He loves everyone. So today's story, remember I showed you the picture of the animals kind of just floating around on that blanket or sheet or whatever? We're going to learn about what that was, because that is in the Bible. In fact, it's in the book of Acts. We've been in Acts for a while now, learning about the early church, but I was just noticing in my Bible, guys, I hope you can see this, it says the Acts of the Apostles. Now, the apostles, that's a word that means followers of Jesus. So these were the early followers of Jesus after he died, after he went back to heaven. These were the apostles that took on the mission to spread the word of God, to spread the gospel. Today we're in Acts chapter 10, and we're going to hear about Peter, who we've heard about many times before. So we're going to learn about Peter, but also a man named Cornelius. And I'm going to go ahead and tell you that Cornelius was a Roman soldier. He was not a Jew. So he was a Gentile. And this has something to do with those animals hanging out in the sky there. You are going to be blown away by this story. So I'm going to let you listen to the story in video form from Acts chapter 10, and then we'll talk about it later.
Cornelius was a Roman soldier. He loved God, helped other people, and prayed to God. One day, God sent an angel to Cornelius. The angel said, "Cornelius, God heard you when you prayed." The angel told Cornelius to send some men into the city to find Peter. So Cornelius sent two servants and one soldier into the city. In the city, Peter went up on the roof of a house to pray. Then Peter saw a vision. A vision is like a dream, but Peter was awake. He saw a big sheet coming down from heaven. In the sheet were all kinds of animals, snakes and lizards and birds. A voice said, "Get up, Peter, eat." But Peter didn't want to. He thought the animals were unclean. A voice said, "God has made these clean." Peter saw the vision three times, and he tried to figure out what it meant. Then the men Cornelius sent into the city found the house where Peter was staying. They told Peter to come to Cornelius's house. So the next day, Peter went with the men. When Peter saw Cornelius, he told him that the good news about Jesus is for all people, not just Jews. "Everyone who believes in Jesus will have their sins forgiven," Peter said. The people there believed. Cornelius, his family, and his friends were baptized, and Peter stayed with them for a few days. God showed Peter that the good news about Jesus is for everyone. God wants believers to tell everyone the good news about Jesus, no matter who they are or what they do. Jesus is the Lord of all.
What a mind-blowing story. That was pretty amazing and a little weird, I would say. Let's talk about this. Peter had a vision. What is a vision? So when I hear vision, I think of my eyes, because vision means seeing. But Peter, it says Peter had a vision. A vision is kind of like a dream, but it happens while you're awake. So dreams, we know, happen when we're asleep, but a vision is something that God had given Peter while he was wide awake. But it was like he was seeing it with his eyes, but maybe it really wasn't there. So Peter had this vision of these animals, and I hope you picked up on the part where he said, I can't eat these animals because they're unclean. And then God explained, or a voice explained to Peter, that anything that God made could be considered clean, should be considered clean. And that goes right along with Cornelius, who was not a Jew. And Peter thought, Cornelius could never serve God because he's not a Jew. But what God was showing Peter through the vision was, just because Cornelius was a Gentile does not mean that he can't love God and serve God. And in fact, he did. God was showing Peter that he loves everyone, and he wants everyone to be saved, no matter what they look like, no matter what their family's like, no matter what country they came from. He loves everyone, Jews and Gentiles. Kids are so smart. So I'm going to let some kids kind of summarize this whole story of Peter and his vision for you. Take a look and take a listen.
Hey kids, can you think of somebody that's different from you? Maybe they wear weird hats or act really strange. Or maybe they just look different from you or speak a different language.
Do those differences make it hard to get to know someone?
Well, in today's story, we're going to talk about how Jesus loves everyone,
no matter how they look or act. Let's get into the story.
Peter had a crazy vision one day. One day, he was praying, and he saw a vision from God.
In Peter's vision, he saw a big white sheet come down from the sky, and on it were a bunch of animals.
Then a voice told him to cook and eat all the animals. Kind of weird, right?
So, what's going on here? The vision was about unclean food.
Back in those days, if you were Jewish like Peter, there were a lot of rules on what you were allowed to eat.
All the animals he saw on the sheet, he wasn't able to eat.
They called them unclean. So why would the voice tell him to eat them all?
Let's see what was really going on. The vision was really about unclean people.
See, back in those days, Jewish people like Peter stayed away from people that were different from them.
They didn't follow God, and they didn't follow the same rules. So they called them unclean, too.
And worst of all, they thought God didn't love them.
That's why God gave Peter this vision, to show him that God loves all people.
So if it's okay to eat that food, it's okay for him to love those people. Peter learned an important lesson that day.
God can make everyone clean. Get it? God loves everyone, and he can make everyone clean. Memory verse.
Do not call something unclean if God has made it clean. Ultimately, everyone is unclean because everyone sins.
And Jesus came and died for everyone so we can all be clean.
This is the lesson that Peter learned. It wasn't about being Jewish. It's about knowing Jesus.
So next time you see someone that's different from you, remember, God loves them just like he loves you.
And that means you should love them too.
Well, you know what this means. It's time to wrap it up. I have my question bag, but before I ask you the questions in this bag about today's lesson of Peter and Cornelius, I want to share our memory verse. So this is the memory verse that we'll study over the next 4 weeks. And it actually comes from the Old Testament today, from the book of 1 Chronicles, chapter 16, verse 31. And I'm going to read from my Bible and tell you what it says. It says, "Let the heavens rejoice, let the earth be glad. Let them say among the nations, the Lord reigns. I'm going to read it one more time. 1 Chronicles 16:31. Let the heavens rejoice. Let the earth be glad. Let them say among the nations, the Lord reigns. Guys, when it says among the nations, it's not talking about one nation. It's not talking about two nations. It's talking about all the nations all over the world. And it tells me that the gospel, the good news, is not just for Americans. It's not just for people with brown hair. It's not just for people who wear glasses. It's not just for Jews. It's for everyone, Jews and Gentiles. God loved us that much that he wanted to see everyone saved. So let's head on into these questions. I hope that you paid really close attention to the story today and you can answer every one of these. And hey, you could quiz your parents or your brother or your sister and see if they listen too. All right, first question says, to whom did God send an angel in our story today? This man was a Roman soldier. His name starts with a C. Cornelius. It's kind of funny. The first part of his name sounds like corn on the cob. Cornelius. Cornelius. Let's see what the second question says. Miss Angie sure does struggle with these things sometimes. I need your little hands to reach in here. I can't wait until we're back together. You can reach in here and get the questions. All right, this one says, what did the angel tell Cornelius to do? Do you remember what the angel said? He told Cornelius to get some men and go get who? Peter. And bring Peter to them. And Cornelius did exactly what the angel told him to do. All right, next question says, what happened when Peter told Cornelius and the other people about Jesus? What happened? They believed in Jesus, and they were baptized. They became believers, and now they were part of the big church. That church was just growing and growing and growing. Last question. Whew, this is about that crazy, sounds crazy to us, vision that Peter had. Why did God give Peter the vision about the animals? What in the world was he trying to communicate to Peter? He was trying to tell Peter that Jesus was not just for the Jewish people. Jesus came for everyone. Everyone. That was a very interesting and good lesson. And I want to tell you before I let you go today that we have scheduled an Easter egg hunt because Easter is just a few weeks away, about a month away, I guess. So we have reserved Bethel Park on Saturday, March the 27th at 2:00. So I want you guys to come on out. We're going to have an egg hunt. We're going to have some crafts. We're going to have a lot of fun. And I'm so anxious to see everyone. So I hope that you will make plans to come. You should be getting more information about that in the mail this week. So check your mailboxes. And I hope you have a wonderful day. I hope that you get to do something fun today, and I hope to see you really, really soon. I hope to see you back here next Sunday for our next Sunday school lesson. I love you guys. Have a great week.